Welcome to this introduction to using SPSS. I'm going to begin by showing you around the SPSS workspace. If you're already familiar with Microsoft Excel, you'll notice that the basic appearance of SPSS is similar to Excel. So for this exercise, I'm going to teach you how to open a new dataset, create variables, enter data, and then save that dataset. Now, this is something you will be doing in almost every SPSS session, so these are important skills for you to master. Now, before I begin, I want to assure you that this is an introduction to SPSS for absolute beginners. I assume that you have absolutely no knowledge of SPSS. You've never used the program before, and this is your first time exploring it. Now, in future videos, I'll go into depth on tricks, shortcuts, features, but in these introductory videos, we're going to start at the very beginning. A very good place to start. I do assume, however, that you are familiar with how to use a computer. I assume that you know how to use either a Mac or a PC. Now, I'll be using Mac for the most part. I assume that you know how to open a program or an application on your computer. I assume that you know how to use a keyboard to type letters and numbers. I assume that you know how to use a mouse so you can navigate. And you know how to left-click and right-click. If you're using a Mac with a single-click mouse or a trackpad, the equivalent to right-clicking is to hold down the control key when you click. And of course, I assume that you have the software already installed on your computer. Those are the basic skills that you need. So with that as background, open the SPSS program on your computer and let's get started. If the icon for SPSS is already on your desktop or in the dock, click it to open SPSS. Alternatively, on a PC, you can choose Start, All Programs, IBM SPSS Statistics, IBM SPSS Statistics 23, or other version if you have it installed. On the Macintosh, you can click through Applications, IBM, SPSS, Statistics, 21 or other number, SPSS Statistics. When you open SPSS, you will be greeted with a splash page. This is a picture that appears when you open a software program as the program is loading. Depending on your computer and the version of SPSS, you may get a warning about Unicode character encoding. If so, just click on Use Unicode Encoding, and that should be the only time that you see that notice. When SPSS loads, the splash page disappears, and then you will see a dialog box that offers shortcuts to various tasks that you might like to perform, such as opening an existing data source, typing in data, or opening another type of file. Your dialog box may look different, however, the menu items will be the same. You may choose to use this initial dialog box as you get more comfortable with SPSS, but I'm not going to teach you about it now. This page only appears when you first open the program. Therefore, if you're already using the program, you need to know where to find these options. I prefer to show you how to find and use the options within the program itself. So click Cancel, and we can get started. The program opens with a blank data set consisting of white boxes. Those boxes are cells where you will type data. They are organized into rows and columns. The columns are vertical. They run up and down, like the columns of a Greek temple. Each column represents a variable. If you are measuring height, weight, and intelligence, you will have one column for height scores, one for weight scores, and one for IQ scores. If you create a new variable for body mass index, you will calculate a whole new variable in its own column. The rows run horizontally. Rows represent cases, or participants. Each participant in your study will have his or her own data in a single row. You never want a single participant's data on multiple rows. We are looking here at the data view. You know this because if you look at the bottom of the screen, you will see a tab labeled Data View. This view is where you enter data. But you will also see another tab called Variable View. Now click on that tab. Here we are in Variable View. This is where you will define variables. And this is an important difference between the way that SPSS and Excel handles data. In Excel, you can have multiple worksheets. Now, each worksheet is like the page in a flip pad. You can flip from one worksheet to the other. They're on top of each other. And there's different data on each one. You can add new worksheets, or copy, or delete, or enter data on any of them. In SPSS, however, you only have one worksheet, or dataset, in which you enter data. If you bring data into SPSS from Excel, and the data are on multiple worksheets, you would need to create a new SPSS dataset for each sheet of Excel data. And by the way, this is usually a bad idea. You want all of your data on a single Excel spreadsheet. Unlike Excel, SPSS has a view in which you define the characteristics of your variable in the variable view, and then you enter the actual numeric data in data view. Click back to data view, and let's enter some numbers. In this first column, let's enter 5, 4, 6, 2, 4, 1. Now, you may have already noticed some changes. These changes will be even more obvious when you go back to variable view. There is new information about the variable. These are the default settings, so let's learn about them. The first column is name, and that is the name of the variable. The name of this variable is VAR00001, which is a horrible name for a variable. We can do much better. Rename this variable scores. In fact, we can create new variables simply by typing a name. In the second row, let's type height. A new variable appears. Now go back to data view, and you can see that you have a new place to enter data about height. Now back to variable view. The second column is type. We have a lot of options here, and these will be important, so let me tell you more about the types of variables in SPSS. The most common type of variable in SPSS is numeric. These are numbers. They can be whole numbers, decimals, single digits, integers, Fibonacci numbers, anything as long as it is a number. Only the values 0 through 9, in any combination, plus decimal points, go in numeric variables. No letters, no spaces, no commas, no special characters. The second type of variable is a string variable. String variables can include numbers, but what makes a variable a string variable is that it has at least one value somewhere that contains a letter. Any letter, anywhere, and the whole variable is string. And of course, there will be times when you do want to use words or names. So, if you wanted to list all of the cars that you own, and one of them is a yellow 1975 AMC Pacer, you would have a numeric variable for year, 1975, and a string variable for yellow, and another string variable for Pacer. You know, the AMC Pacer is one of the ugliest cars ever made. It looks like a fishbowl on wheels. However, string variables cannot be analyzed like numeric variables. So if you are going to use categorical variables like male and female, yellow, red, blue, you can make them numeric. You simply assign them a number, like 1 equals male and 2 equals female, or 1 equals yellow, 2 equals red, 3 equals blue. Other options available for variable types are date, with multiple options for specifying the year, month, day, or hour, minute, second, and scientific notation, if you are using very small or very large numbers. What you should remember is that numeric variables are your friends, and you should avoid string, currency, date, and other variables unless you really need them and you know what you're doing. We will use numeric variables almost exclusively. So let's go back to variable view. The variable settings that you will use the most are name, for creating a new variable, decimal for setting the number of decimals that appear in data view, label, values, and measure. I will explain those settings in detail in a video about creating variables. The settings that you will not use very much are width, which you use to establish how wide or narrow the entries can be for string variables, column, which is used to establish how wide or narrow the column will be in data view, align, which is used to format your entries as left, right, or center. This is done automatically. And missing, by which you instruct SPSS on how to handle missing values. Now, these settings can be important at other times, but these are not the ones that we'll be using the most. Notice that column is, by default, set to the value of 8. So let's go back to data view. You can adjust column widths with your cursor, and then when you go back to variable view, the column value will have changed. Okay, that's your introduction to the SPSS workspace. Next time, we're going to create some variables that can be used for analysis.